Okay, so let me start with an introduction about me. I have a degree in statistics and economics at the University of Milano Bicocca. 4 years ago, I joined in the data analytics team of EY. And last year, I started the master in big data and business intelligence of Milano Bicocca when I started to study about explainability with the professor Fabio Mercorio. And now I'm working in Intesa San Paolo. We build machine learning models for all of the group structures. And we have also a stream of study in explainability and fairness with Riccardo Crupi, Daniele Regoli, and Greta Greco, who are connect here. So this is our agenda. We will start with an introduction and motivation. Why we need interpretability in bank, then we will see a real use case, and then we will go inside a more technical aspect about explainability and fairness, and at the finish, as I promise, we will see a Jupyter notebook. So, why we need interpretability in the bank sector? I summarize the reason in three macro areas, of course, regulatory and compliance. When we take a decision according to the output of machine learning models, we need to be able to provide the explanation about that. So we can just say this is the output of our black box. We need to be able to explain that. Then adoption and acceptance. I'm sure that most of you had developed machine learning models in the past. But I am also sure that only few of that then really go to production. This is because most of the time the people of the business doesn't understand our models and doesn't trust our models. So explainability is very important to spread trust. And at the end, reducing risk, like brand reputation. So when we train a black box, our model learn from the data. And if there is some discrimination in our data, then the model will learn that as a rules. So with explainability, we can see if in our models there is some unfairness, and we have to try to remove or reduce that. So this is a use case in credit risk scores. So we need to know the customer level of risk scores in order to take some credit decision. And a customer, if the credit is denied, has the legal right to ask the reason why. So we build an AI solution because he allows us to process all of the information about the client and produce the higher performance credit score models. So after we train our black box, we need some blocks that explain that. So explainability is important to provide a fully transparent framework for our client, prevent potential discrimination, and avoid the risk of such sanction. So it is only one use case, but we can use explainability every time so we need to build an AI models. So, but what is explainability? So we use the local agnostic explanator. Local means that the result of the model is for a single observation. So think about the importance matrix coming from a random forest. This is an example of explainer global. So we don't want to see the global explanation about black box, but the local. So we need to explain the prediction about one single row. And local agnostic explanator do that. Agnostic means that works for every model. We only need the probability in output. So it could be good with random forest, logistic regression, XGBoost, neural network. Every different models allow us to use an agnostic explanator. So, as I said, in input, we need only just a single row or single observation and a trained black box model. Then, starting the points that we provide, the explainer generate random records in the neighborhood of the first one and weigh that according of the theory about our explanator. Every different explainer have a different theory behind that. And after we generate all the record, we provide for each the prediction according to the trained black box model that we give in input. And at the end, we fit a linear regression with as a target the prediction of our black box, and in the input, the record that we had generated. So the weights of our linear regression or other transparent by design models is the explanation about our observation. So this is the concept behind an explainer. Of course, there is some more things, there is some things more difficult, but this is a very basic idea behind that. And here, a presentation about fairness. What is the hardest things in fairness? Is getting a definition who is shared by everyone. So I could have a definition of fairness, could be, and it could be different for another person. So we need to understand our use case and also take some guidelines that say us what kind of fairness we need to provide. I present you here a very strange measure of fairness with disparate impact testing, who wants that the probability of getting one target be equal for every different classes from a protected attribute. So for example, if we provide allowance, we want the probability to getting allowance for the man must be the same for the woman. And if we haven't this fairness, we need to remove that. And for that, we have three different classes of methods. We have pre-process methods who want to provide a training test without discrimination in order to get our black box model able to learn from train without discrimination, or training time methods who fit some constraint inside our black box model who avoid the discrimination, or methods in the pre-processing who are like choosing different threshold for the different classes. So this is the idea about explainability and fairness. For explain better to you the explanation, I will provide you a notebook. So here we are. I used an open data about the credit because I can share, of course, the data coming from my company. In this application, we have the credit history, the purpose, saving account, employment status, the sex, and other information about the credits. And in our application, we have a target one when we have a critical account, and target zero when we haven't a critical account, so a low risk. So we train the models. I used a neural network because it's the hardest black box to explain. And I get a ROC of 0.8. Yes, of course, maybe we can get a better score, but it is our autoscope for our application. And this is the distribution of our prediction in the two target classes. So we have problems in here when we get an high precision for target zero, and here when we have low prediction for target one. So the idea behind explainability is see if the reason behind our prediction is current, even if we provide a wrong prediction. So we want to see that. I choose two observations. as I said, it is local. So I want to see a true positive and one false positive. So here is the reason behind our true positive. So according to this explanation, we predict a nice score because it has a poor saving account, it is unemployed, and he have three credits. So it could be reasonable. The concept behind here is see if it's coherent with an expert of business. So if our explanation is not current, we need to go back and refit our models. And here we have an explanation behind our wrong prediction. So here our prediction is very high, but our true value is zero. But as we can say here, the explainability is very similar to the instance before. So we have two credits, we have a poor saving account, unemployment status. So as a data scientist, we could be upset because our prediction is wrong. But with this explanation, we can be confident about our models. So this is the reason about an explanation. Even if we provide some wrong prediction, we need to be able to explain a solid motivation about that. One thing that I don't like in this explanation is that we give an importance to sex equal to woman to getting an high risk. So we could have some unfairness problem. So we need to remove that. First of all, we want to quantify unfairness. As we can see here, we have unfairness in the very beginning data. So in the starting data set, we have a higher probability for the woman to get a high score. And so our model learned that. And we can see the difference in probability to getting an high risk score from the woman. So we want to remove unfairness, and for doing that, I use the methods of oversampling. So first of all, I'm going to see the quantity of every combination in the sex and the target. So we have four different combinations, and we want that the ratio for women must be the same from the ratio for men. Now, of course, it's different. And we calculate that the optimal quantity is 26 to 42 to getting the optimal option for the man that is the same for the woman. So we are going to oversample this part of the data set only on the training. Now, after the oversampling, we have pretty the same quantity for women and for men. And then we fit our neural network in the new training dataset. So after that, we want to test that in the starting test dataset who haven't received any oversampling. So the ratio is not the same in the test set, but we want to see if the discrimination must be removed, and as we can say, we have now the same probability each for men and for women. And now our disparate impact test is very near to one, and our ROC is still height like before. So we were like in this application, in most of the case, having remove unfairness means losing performance, and in this case, we need to choose the better trade-off for our application, but in this case, we was lucky. So this is the end of my presentation. I'm here if you have some questions.